code, and you can also read the content whatever given by the school. So once after you click on this, so once after you click on this, so this PDF will be opened. So you can see all the previous announcements also which are uploaded. And if you want to go through a particular announcement, just click on that particular announcement. It will be taking you to that particular announcement, and you can view, and you can download the photograph, or you can download the PDF, whatever the school has given to. The same way, we have other options like event calendar. So event calendar is nothing but like a school calendar type of thing, where you can view all the like holidays, all the examinations, all the general events which are happening in the school. So once the staff uploads those particular events, so you can see the events from here. And then you have one more option as gallery. So in gallery, you will get the option like, see, if any events are happening in the school, those events will be taken, I mean, an image will be taken for that particular event, and the same photograph can be uploaded in the photo gallery, where you can download it from here and you can save those images in your device. So after event calendar, gallery and messages option is there. This is a type of like messages, like you can communicate. See, in web we have given the option of composing of a particular message and you can send it. This is not like a only SMS. This is a option which we have given in my class board. Like, for example, if I am having my class board ID and the student is, or a parent is having my class board ID, so once after they log in, they can communicate from my class board to my class board. So like this, you can view the messages, and you have a discipline log. So once after the school uploads the discipline, if any discipline logs are there, you can view the discipline logs. And you have an option of apply leave. This is like a intimation of leave intimation. So just you will click on this apply leave, and it will be redirected to some other page, and there you can just apply the leave from here, add leave, add new, and you can give the information why you are taking leave. This is not an approval based type of thing, it's a leave intimation type of thing. And also the one of the module is digital document library, where you have to upload the documents or certificates. Here in this particular option there, we have given many options in which you can upload, like birth certificate, passport, visa, photographs, all those you can upload here. And all those you can upload here, and the same can be downloaded from here in this particular option. Here right now it is showing no data found. Once after you upload the documents, all the documents will be shown here, and the same documents can be downloaded in your device. And how you will upload is just click on this upload new document, select, let us take, I'm selecting child passport. Here I will type the description. Here there is an option of attach file here. Just I click on this attach file here. Here you can see there are three options which are available: document, gallery, and photo camera. So once after you click on document, so it will be giving you option to select the PDF send all. If you select gallery, images, and if you want to take picture here itself, by clicking on that camera will be opened. You can take the photograph and you can upload it. So like this, you can upload the documents. And also if you want to apply for a gate pass, so here you can see there is an option of gate pass. Once after you click on gate pass, so here we have given different options like pickup, and also you have an option of plus. This is for the gate pass entry for a particular day. That means if any parent tells like, I will be taking my kid from 16th April to 20th April, I will be taking my kid by 2 o'clock. Just they will give here, and they will send the reason why they are applying for this gate pass, and this will be sent to the approval to principal. Once principal approves, then a QR code will be generated, and it will be showing here in the today pre-approved gate pass. So a QR code will be generated. That QR code will be scanned by the school security or from school front office also. So once after they scan, then it will be validated, and a record will be updated as yes, today you have taken your gate like that. So this is how you can apply for the gate pass. And also, if you want to change password, we have given option to change password here. So you can see it will be asking for the old password, new password, and confirm password. Once after you give these details, the password will be changed according to the inputs. And also you have option to view the profile. By clicking on this profile, the details, the basic details will be opening here. And also you can see there is an option of edit. So once after you click on this edit, so whatever the edit rights are given by the staff, school admin staff, will be viewed here. All those details you can save here. And you can see the parent details also here. We are asking for the basic details. So here you can also update the basic details. And address details. We'll be asking you for the address, present address, and permanent address. So this is how you can update your data. And also note one thing, if school have disabled that particular option, you can't see the edit option. And if you want to add sibling, in the starting of the screen also you can add. Again, here also we have an option to add the sibling. From here also you can add. If the sibling is already added, here it will not show. Okay, sir. So the app you have to download is ISWK Parent Portal. So if I shall I show it in the Play Store also? Just a minute. So you can see this is ISWK Parent Portal. Search here with ISWK Parent Portal. And the first one you can see is the parent portal which you need to download. Hope I'm clear, sir.
Yeah, I think everything is clear now for them.
Yes. Yes. So shall I show the web portal also, sir, once?
Yeah, better.
Yes, sir. I will be logging with the parent portal. So you can see this is the URL which you need to use is iswk.myclassbook.com. You can see on the top.
Okay.
So iswk.
Okay. Login from the beginning. I think yes. You entered okay. Already, Ishan.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay, sir. I will. Yes, sir. So you have to give iswk.myclassbook.com. Sorry. Just a minute, sir.
Okay.
So you can see iswk.myclassbook.com. Once after you give the URL, this is the homepage which will be showing. Here you will give the username and here you will give the password. So here like this, you will give the username and password. Once after you click on login, so this page will be opening. Same. This is a parent portal. Also, I need to tell you one more thing. Like in the parent portal only, the fee details will be showing. If you have logged in with the student portal, the fee details option will not show. So right now, I am logged in with the parent logins. So that is why you can see siblings also here. So if you once after I log in, these are the details like here, sign here, and this particular student is there. Like if you want to view this particular student, portal, if you have to click on this particular student and you can see those details only here, this particular student details, and you can see here the announcements, latest announcement which are given here. And if you want to see more So you just click on the ERP dashboard, and here again one dashboard will be opening here with the attendance. Okay, so I don't want to see this. If you want to see all the options, just click on show more, and all the options will be showing here, like timetable, starting with the timetable. So if the timetable is uploaded, you can see all the timetable here. And if you want to view the attendance, just click on attendance. And same how we have used in the mobile app, same way you can view here by clicking on this month name, you can view the attendance device. And then here you have an option of documents or certificates like this. So you have an option of upload student documents, where you can upload all the documents which are mandatory here. So you have to upload all this. And also you have an option of download certificates. So if any bona fide and tax certificates are issued, then only you can download. So if it is right now, nothing are enabled, so you are not able to see anything. And then announcements, if you want to view the announcements, you can see the announcements which are posted here. If you want to view a particular announcement, just click on view more, and you can download this particular PDF and you can read. And if any policy manuals are uploaded, you can see in the particular tab here itself, we have an option of policy manuals. If any policy manuals are uploaded, you can see here and you can download it in the PDFs. Also, we have an option of chat. So like this is nothing but, as I said before, there is a My Class Board to My Class Board communication can be happened. So for that, this particular chat would be useful. Like you have an option to click on compose, and you can write any message to particular subject teacher or a class teacher or principal. So you can type here a subject, you can write a description, and you can send it. It will be reaching to a particular staff to whom you have selected. And you have an option of like pay or view fees is there. So same how we have the option. So just select here and click on continue. It will be redirected to the payment gateway, and the payment will be happening. So if you want to view the transactions, just click on AY transactions. So you can take the receipts from here. Whatever you have paid before, you can take a printout from here itself. And also you have fee details option is available, where you can see fee type wise total amount to be paid, if any discount is given, what is the paid amount and balance amount.
Okay.
And then you have option of report cards. So in this year, right now the report cards are not enabled, but if you want to view the previous year's report card, just click here the last academic year. So automatically overall is already selected. So you can view the report card of the particular student, and you can take print. That means print is nothing but you can print and you can save it as PDF. In the same way, you have evaluation report card is also there. So in the evaluation report card also, change the academic year and you will get the evaluation report card also. So like this, you can download this report cards of previous academic years as well. And you have like daily class log. That means the diary, whatever given by the staff, will be seen here in daily class log. And then school calendar, which I have explained in the app, like a event calendar, whatever the details are uploaded in the school. So you can see all those here in the school calendar. If any holiday, examination, general, everything you can see here. And then photo gallery is there. In the photo gallery, as I said, there are events, there will be events conducted in the school. The photographs will be taken in the school, and those photographs will be uploaded in the system in the photo gallery option, where you can download it and you can view here in this particular photo gallery option. And then you have gate pass, which I have shown there. So in the gate pass, you have a request for pickup and request for pre-approved gate pass. So if you want to, as I said, from date to date, if you are having like this, so go to request for pre-approved gate pass, and here select the dates from this particular date to this particular date. I will be taking my kid at 2 p.m. So you can select that particular date and time, and this will be sent to the approval of principal. Once after principal and QR code, once principal approves, then a QR code will be generated. The same way health details are there, where you can view the health details, and if you want to see view health history also there. Whatever the health details uploaded in the school can be viewed here in this particular health details option. Then you have TC request if you want to apply for a particular TC. So here you have an option of TC request where like you can select the reason, you can write the remarks, you can give the school name and all. If it is for other schools, just click on other school and whatever the free details are there will be shown here. And according to the policies of the school, you have to apply the TC and the process will be happened from the school. And then in LMS, we have separate part as LMS. Here you have assignments option is there, where there are two options are available. One is online and one is offline. Offline is nothing but you can only view and you have to write the assignment, you have to take back to the school. Online means this is purely online, like the staff will send an assignment to you, to the parent or a student. So the student or student will write the assignment. The same can be taken, a photograph can be taken for that particular assignment answers. It will be re-uploaded in the system. The whatever you have uploaded will be corrected by the staff online and they will resubmit it to you back. So this is the two-way communication type of thing. Staff to parent or student to staff again, and again staff to parent. This is how the communication will be happened in the online assignments. And also you have option of online examinations or worksheets. So online examinations conducted from the school. So those online examinations can be seen here. We have separated into objective and summative. Summative means you have to write and you have to take a photograph and you have to upload it. Objective means a timer will be set or a self-paced, the date will be given. So in that particular time period, you need to submit your answers. This is a type of multiple choice, match the following passage questions. So all these will be in the objective examinations, which will be auto-corrected by the system. And then you have an option of learning league. Learning league is nothing but our discussion form. A teacher will raise a topic and against that particular topic, the students can conversate in that particular option. And then you have learning option is there. Like as I said, in learning, so all the subjects, you can see all the subjects here. And for each and every subject, if a content will be uploaded, if you want to read, just you will go to that particular chapter. And if you want, you can see there are some videos which are given. Once after you click on these videos, so you can go to these options and you can read accordingly. Okay. So if you want to change the password, just go to the home page by clicking on this logo. It will be going back to the home page and you have an option of change password. So once you click on change password, it will be asking you to give the old password and you have to give the new password and confirm the new password. That's it. And if any notifications are there, here you can see in the notification icon. And if you want to switch the student, just click on this particular student, it will be switched. Yes, sir. Sir, I hope I'm clear.
Yeah, Lokesh. Yeah, you are clear. Still, some of the parents are asking how to log in as a parent, but that I think our IT department will guide them.
Yes. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
We can proceed for next now.
Thank you, Mr. Lokesh. Parents, I sincerely request you to please download the app. This will help to connect better. Please do explore the various features of the app. I now request the principal to please address the parents and Mr. Sean, sir, to please take up the questions posed by the parents in the Q&A.
Yes, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
A couple of points and questions posted in the chat box. The first one has already been taken care of. It says over here how to place orders for books in the app. That I guess Mr. Lokesh has already made clear. Another parent is asking if teachers want to convey anything to parents, just a note or reminder regarding books, will they be uploaded here?
Textbooks, they mean to say?
I guess so, sir. That's correct.
Maybe we can give that e-textbooks type, like soft copies we can upload for each class till they get the hard copies of the textbooks. This can be supplement to that. Because particularly what happened now, there is a confusion now. Teachers are asking textbooks from the children, or notebooks or textbooks. But now they don't have the textbooks or notebooks issued by the school. So there is a big confusion now. So actually, teachers also should know that the books have to come from India. If they are locally available, we will be able to make it available immediately in a day or two. But due to the pandemic, everyone has financial constraint. So we are not in a position to advance the money and bring the books for entire school. And later on, if the parents do not purchase the books, that books will become like extra stock in the school. We don't want to have that type of it. So here afterwards, the school will be supplying the books, the textbooks or notebooks, against the payment well in advance, so that only who are all ordering books through the school, for them we will be able to supply. But suddenly, on the spot, if you want to buy one or two notebooks or some stationery, that will be available from the bookstore. But the textbooks and all, they will not be available as and when they want it. So here afterwards, maybe for this session, most of the people, what they did now, only 20% of the people made an order to the school. So that we already bought and we purchased the books and we distributed to the parents also. Now the fresh lot is coming up. So that fresh lot, who are all applying, who are all purchasing the books, those books will be given only after the summer vacation, because we have to place the order and we are going to make a window open. And that window will be again, available for certain days. We can make the payment, and then as I'm just mentioning that, we will take the order from the parents. Most probably by the end of this month, we'll close that orders again. So whoever wants to place the order, they can place the order with the school. So from there, maybe if possible, by the end of May, we try to get it. No, maximum by the reopening date of after summer vacation, we will be able to deliver the books. Till such time, all the textbooks or notebooks who are not having it, try to adjust with. I think this is even teachers also, please note down. Student-wise, who are having textbooks, who are not having textbooks, who are having notebooks, who are not having notebooks. So this problem will be there only for this year. Next year onwards, again, the same process will continue, but well in advance, we'll take the order from the parents, for the notebooks and textbooks.
Thank you, sir. Another parent over here states the fact that there is some email ID, etc., that she needs to get from the school. So all I can tell the parent is that if there were any IT-related issues, please send an email to itsupport@iswkoman.com. So those, email IDs or whether they are, IDs or passwords, all those issues will be taken care of. The same parent, sir, asks.
Sir, one minute. Here, in the beginning, we will have this type of some sort of hiccups and problems of communication. Let class teacher or subject teachers try to even accommodate the parents' queries. And then if suppose IT has to address, from our side, we can also ask IT department to help the so-and-so parents. So whoever required that type of email ID or user ID or password. And as Lokesh demonstrated very well, mobile application gives better solutions for the people. Even when they are traveling, so everybody has today a smart mobile. So in that, either Android mobile or iOS mobile. So either it is Android phone or iPhone. So you will be able to download that app. And then as a parent, when you log in, all the two children or three children or one child, whatever the number of children studying at school, their data will be available. Academic data will be available. Financial data will be available. Other notifications also available. And about the events and school calendar. So that this is like a better communication tool from the school to the parents. Even all the circulars which we are issuing. Sometimes children may not carry the circulars and hand it over to the parent. But this is now uploaded in, all the circulars are going to be uploaded in the our ERP system. So therefore, they will be able to see and let actually, Seema madam, my special request to you, class one wise, how many parents are logged in? How many parents are using mobile app? How many parents are logged in through web portal? And what they are actually browsing it? Let's just see that. And now let's encourage more number of parents to use this one. So it will become more communicative. So let's have a statistics of class-wise, class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5. So therefore, if there are parents not using it, we will communicate to them. We'll find out the reasons why they are not able to use it. If there are any difficulties, we'll try to address those difficulties so that effective communications avoids a lot of communication gap. So therefore, that both are well in advance informed about the, any school activity or any competitions, child can be prepared very well, either it is academics or any other activities. Okay?
Right, sir. So the same parent says that they are currently in India and they haven't procured books as yet. So is it okay if they can procure the books from India itself and then come back?
No issues at all. They can purchase the books in India and come back. We are not going to make any business deal in this now. Let me make it very clear to the parents. So in India, actually, some of the private schools, they force the parents, you must buy the books from the school only. You must buy the uniform from the school only. Like that, everything that you need to buy only from school. But here, it is not that mandatory at all. We wanted to only play a role of facilitating between the parent and the school. So if you are trying to get the books from the India, yes, nothing like that. But follow the book list, what we are giving, the same books only you have to purchase, not the books what they follow in India.
Right, sir. So the next query is also again with regard to books, where the parent says that they have paid the required amount but have not received the book as yet. And
this is what happened now, Mr. Shan. Yes. Actually, after the first lot, which is placed order by the parents, we already distributed. So you all know that. Now the parents, we opened the portal to see that how many are interested in that. So some of the parents paid it. But today, books are not available with us. We have to bring the books from India. That also, there are two ways to get the books from India. One is through air freight, which is very, very costly. If the book cost is, for example, say 2 riyal, they collect from us 10 times of that. So that will be very difficult. So next one, through port, sea travel. So that takes little, economical. So we wanted to go by that actually. So that's why I told you, the procuring the textbooks and notebooks will take minimum of 5 to 6 weeks time. So we will try our maximum, our level best to give the books by the end of this May. No, if it is not possible, only after summer vacation. So that is from 1st August or 2nd August onwards, we'll issue the books again. Till such time, let our class teachers not insist the children to bring the books, textbooks and all. Let our class teachers share the e-books now, soft copies of the books to them.
Right, sir. Again, there are a few queries with regard to, login IDs, etc. We've already told this to the parent, and I'll reiterate myself once again. Parents, if you have any issues with regard to IT work, please email itsupport@iswkoman.com and your issues and queries will be taken care of. So other questions actually pertain to what we will be orienting parents on after your address. So we'll follow that immediately.
Sean, actually what I suggest is now today, maybe I will be moving to another meeting. You can answer, you and Mrs. Shashi Madam can answer all the questions which are coming now after the orientation program.
Okay. So we could also make a copy of the same, prepare the relevant answers and circulate it amongst the parents.
Let us encourage the parents to pose the questions through this portal. Yes. Let them, whatever the questions which are, we are getting it, we will take up all the questions and make like FAQs. Yes. And then all these FAQs with proper answers. So if it is one-to-one type of it, we'll write only to them. If it is general one, so that every parent will get benefit of it, that we will send it to all. Okay?
That's correct. Thank you, sir. Then we'll do as you just advised. Everything is very clear here. Anyway, thank you, sir. Seema ma'am, it's over to you, please.
Thank you, sir. And thank you, parents. We will definitely support you for all the queries that you have posed over here. To begin our orientation now, I request Ms. Sucheta Jaswani and Ms. Sucheta Chawla to take us through the program for English and Hindi.
Thank you, Seema ma'am. Good afternoon, dear parents. I once again welcome you all to the virtual orientation for classes 1 and 2. COVID-19 played a pivotal role in rearrangement of educational pedagogy. It led to the disruption of physical bond between a teacher and a student. However, it was instrumental in digitalization of the system and a focused approach to maximize learning. The world now is on the recovery mode, and Indian school Al-Wadi Al-Kabir is no exception. We are striving harder than before to build our contact and confidence among students and parent community. We are earnestly following the quote of Gandhiji, education is all round drawing of the best in child, in body, mind, and spirit. Before I get into the details of our strategies for the same, I, along with my colleagues, Ms. Sakina Patla, who will help us with the presentation, and Mrs. Sucheta Chawla, who represents the Hindi department, will introduce you to the team of dedicated teachers. At class 1, we have Ms. Anita and Ms. Jacinta as academic coordinators, along with the hardworking team of teachers who are Ms. Anuradha, Ms. Mosmi, Ms. Hemin, Ms. Sheila Mary, Ms. Teresa, Ms. Savita, and Ms. Sabina. At class 2, I, as the academic coordinator, leading the enthusiastic team of teachers, which comprises of Ms. Annie, Ms. Renuka, Ms. Sakina, Ms. Mariam, Ms. Anisa, Ms. Vanessa, Ms. Samira, Ms. Aditi, Ms. Suja, and Ms. Jayalakshmi.
Namaskar, dear parents. Main Sucheta Chawla, Hindi Vibhag ki or se online orientation mein aap sabka hardik abhinandan karti hun. Orientation ke kram ko आगे बढ़ाने से पहले कक्षा 1 और 2 के नन्हे प्यारे बच्चों की अध्यापिकाओं से आपको अवगत कराती हूँ। सुश्री हेमलता एकेडमिक कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ हिंदी डिपार्टमेंट प्राइमरी विंग, श्रीमती सुचेता चावला, श्रीमती द्रोपति होतवानी, श्रीमती मुस्लिम जहान, श्रीमती रिंकू तन्ना, श्रीमती जसप्रीत कौर। भाषा भावों की अभिव्यक्ति है। Children start learning Hindi from class 1. यहाँ उन्हें हिंदी की बेसिक नॉलेज दी जाती है जिसे कक्षा दो में कंटिन्यू किया जाता है। आइए अब कक्षा एक और दो की बुक्स के बारे में जानते हैं। बुक्स फॉर क्लास वन। वन रीडर टेक्स्ट बुक कम वर्कबुक अबीर हिंदी पाठमाला भाग एक और फॉर राइटिंग सिंगल लाइन हिंदी नोटबुक विद फोर कॉलम्स। वन हिंदी वर्कबुक। पेरेंट्स प्लीज नोट, कक्षा में कराए गए लेटर्स की प्रैक्टिस बच्चे घर पर इस वर्कबुक में कर सकते हैं। बुक्स फॉर क्लास टू। वन रीडर टेक्स्ट बुक कम वर्कबुक अबीर हिंदी पाठमाला भाग दो फॉर राइटिंग सिंगल लाइन हिंदी नोटबुक।
एट क्लासेस वन एंड टू वी हैव द न्यू इमेजेस, अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इंग्लिश कोर्स एज द टेक्स्टबुक। एट क्लास वन देयर इज ओनली वन नोटबुक which is combined for prose and language work. However, in class 2, we have two books separately for prose and language work. At both the levels, the cursive script is done with separate books for it. Learning of any language requires interaction of four basic skills of listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Let us now focus on each skill and the way it is taught at school. Listening in English is taught and developed through listening exercises in the textbook and oral comprehension. The sources used for oral comprehension are podcasts and audiobooks. Students listen to the text and answer to the questions based on it. Here are the examples of the worksheets at both the levels and the audiobooks used at class 2 level.
Listening skill. किसी भी बात को सही प्रकार से समझने के लिए सुनने की क्षमता को डेवलप करना जरूरी है। हमारे बच्चे भी लिसनिंग स्किल से अपनी छोटे छोटे इंस्ट्रक्शन को सुनते हैं और उन्हें फॉलो करते हैं, जैसे खड़े हो जाओ, बैठ जाओ, किताब निकालो। इसके अलावा बच्चे छोटी छोटी कविताएं, कहानियों को सुनकर तथा देखकर उसे समझने की कोशिश करते हैं। स्पीकिंग स्किल। हम जो सुनते हैं वही बोलते हैं। कक्षा एक के कई बच्चे हिंदी में बात नहीं कर पाते हैं, परंतु वे सीखे हुए वर्ड्स को बोलने का प्रयास करते हैं। कक्षा दो में आते आते वे छोटे छोटे सेंटेंसेस बोलना शुरू कर देते हैं। बच्चों की स्पीकिंग स्किल को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए क्लास एक्टिविटी भी कराई जाती है। इसके अलावा क्लास असेंबलीज, हिंदी कॉन्सर्ट्स, जिनके द्वारा बच्चों को हिंदी बोलने के लिए प्रोत्साहित किया जाता है। इस साल क्लास वन में हिंदी रेसिटेशन कंपटीशन है और क्लास टू में हिंदी स्टोरी टेलिंग कॉम्पिटिशन है।
स्पीकिंग स्किल्स आर डेवलप्ड थ्रू क्लास असेंबलीज, classroom discussions, poetry recitations, competitions, and impromptu speaking on any topic in the class. Besides, the storytelling competition and the use of blend words are also taught at class 2 level. Reading is done through reading of seen and unseen passages, model reading by the teacher, and individual reading by the students, reading cards and reading comprehensions, e-books, virtual and class library, reading competition, for example, read-a-thon organized at class 1 level.
रीडिंग स्किल क्लास एक में बच्चे सिखाए गए लेटर्स वर्ड्स एवं सेंटेंसेस पढ़ते हैं और क्लास टू में आकर वे छोटे छोटे पाठों को पढ़ना शुरू कर देते हैं। राइटिंग स्किल कक्षा एक में बच्चों को लेटर्स की सही फॉर्मेशन के साथ लिखना सिखाया जाता है, फिर इन लेटर्स से बनने वाले शब्दों और शब्दों से बच्चा आगे चलकर छोटे छोटे सेंटेंस बनाना सीखता है। कक्षा दो में बच्चे पाठ से रिलेटेड शब्दार्थ वाक्य रचना और प्रश्न उत्तर के द्वारा अपनी लेखनी की क्षमता को निखारते हैं। क्लास वन में बच्चे इंग्लिश लेटर से फैमिलियर होते हैं तो उसी को बेस बनाते हुए उन्हें हिंदी के लेटर भी लिखना सिखाया जाता है। फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेटर र सिखाने के लिए हम इंग्लिश अल्फाबेट जे का बेस बनाते हुए उन्हें समझाते हैं। जैसे कि आप स्लाइड में देख सकते हैं, फर्स्ट राइट लेटर जे, देन फ्रॉम इट्स टेल ड्रॉ अ स्लांटिंग लाइन डाउनवर्ड्स, देन ड्रॉ अ स्लीपिंग लाइन ऑन द टॉप। र इजी, इन लेटर्स को जोड़कर बच्चा शब्द बनाना सीखता है। बच्चों को मात्राएं भी सिखाई जाती हैं और हर एक मात्रा से कुछ शब्द करवाए जाते हैं। पेरेंट्स प्लीज नोट, जो अक्षर हम नोटबुक में करवाते हैं उसी लेटर को रीडर बुक में भी करवाया जाएगा। फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेटर अ इज ऑन पेज नंबर 11 एंड लेटर ब इज ऑन पेज नंबर 54। हमारा कहने का उद्देश्य है रीडर बुक सीक्वेंस में नहीं जाएगी।
इन क्लास वन द स्टूडेंट्स आर टॉट टू फ्रेम मीनिंगफुल सेंटेंसेस ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर गिवन टॉपिक एज यू कैन सी इन द एग्जाम्पल। द सेम स्किल इज ट्रांसफर्ड इन क्लास टू as paragraph writing, wherein students describe a given topic in a paragraph format without numbering the sentences. At both the levels, picture comprehension is done, wherein student observes the given picture and answers to the questions based on it. In picture composition, the student observes the given picture and describes it. Additionally, in class two, creative writing is done, which is an open-ended worksheet. Students observe the pictures and write as per their imagination. Last but not the least, students are also taught using a dictionary in class two. The language structure portions of classes 1 and 2 are similar. In class 2, a more in-depth knowledge of the structure is received with higher levels of difficulty.
चलिए अब portion के बारे में जानते हैं। Portion for class 1, वर्णमाला, दस खड़ी, मात्राएं, अ से औतक, अनुस्वार और अनुनासिक अर्थात बिंदु चंद्र बिंदु, पिक्चर रीडिंग, संयुक्त अक्षर अर्थात कंपाउंड लेटर और री लेटर। पेरेंट्स आपकी जानकारी के लिए बता दूं कि संयुक्त अक्षर तथा री केवल इंट्रोड्यूस किया जाएगा, एग्जाम में नहीं पूछा जाएगा। इसके अलावा हिंदी में पार्ट्स ऑफ बॉडी, वेजिटेबल्स, फ्रूट्स, कलर, एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स, फ्लावर्स के नाम भी सिखाए जाएंगे। साल के मिड तक आते आते हिंदी फ्रेम सेंटेंसेस भी करवाए जाते हैं। पोर्शन फॉर क्लास टू, कक्षा एक से बच्चे सभी मात्राएं सीख कर आते हैं। कक्षा दो में हम वर्णमाला, दस खड़ी का रिवीजन करवाते हुए संयुक्त अक्षर से आरंभ करते हैं। हाफ लेटर वर्ड्स, र के रूप, ग्रामर स्ट्रक्चर में लिंग, वचन, समानार्थी, विलोम शब्द से परिचित कराया जाता है। पिक्चर रीडिंग, रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन। हर लेसन से वर्ड मीनिंग, फ्रेम सेंटेंसेस, क्वेश्चन आंसर, संज्ञा और क्रिया नोटबुक में करवाए जाते हैं। मैं यहाँ पर आपको बताना चाहूंगी कि पाठ में कई शब्द होते हैं, लेकिन हम केवल 5 से 6 शब्द नोटबुक में लिखवाते हैं और वही एग्जाम में पूछे जाते हैं। हर टॉपिक से रिलेटेड चैप्टर चेकअप, वर्कशीट कराई जाती हैं। भाषा को रुचिकर बनाने के लिए कई एक्टिविटीज भी करवाई जाती हैं, जैसे टॉपिक से रिलेटेड आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस आर्ट इंटीग्रेटेड एक्टिविटी।
आर्ट इंटीग्रेशन इज ऑल्सो डन इन इंग्लिश फॉर वेरियस लेसन्स एंड ग्रामर स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड फॉर सब्जेक्ट एनरिचमेंट एक्टिविटीज टू। Collaboration between home and school is vital as both of us are working for the well-being of the child. So here are a few guidelines for you, dear parents. Encourage your child to speak in full sentences in both English and Hindi, even at home. Start by short phrases of instructions. Make reading fun. Read to your children and ask them to read to you too. As the children start writing the cursive script in class 1, please give them practice at home. Children need to be encouraged to write creative pieces. Let them use their imagination and write about anything and everything they want. Making mistakes is a part of growing up. It is natural, so let them make mistakes. Please motivate and appreciate them for their every initiative. Inculcate life skills like being responsible and self-reliant. Allow them to look into the timetable and pack their bags for the next day to school. Being responsible for one's books, worksheets, work assignments, and belongings. Most importantly, spend quality time with them as a family. Take interest in their interests and their life at school.
So, dear parents, आप और हम मिलकर बच्चों के उज्जवल भविष्य के लिए कार्य करें और उन्हें हिंदी सिखाकर अपने देश की मिट्टी से जोड़ें तथा कई भाषाओं में भी निपुण होने का प्रयास करें। धन्यवाद। Now I call upon my colleague, Miss Jacinta Kwan.
Thank you, Suchita ma'am. A very good morning to one and all. I, Jacinta Kwan, along with me is my colleague, Mrs. Anuradha Sharma. We will guide you through the ways and means of teaching mathematics in classes 1 and 2. Mathematics is an integral part of our day-to-day life. Mathematical thinking is a tool. There is no point in acquiring it unless you mean to use it. In other words, it is not the sums that are important, but the ability to use the knowledge in your day-to-day activities. Mathematics is a powerful tool for the development of critical as well as creative thinking and decision-making. Keeping this in mind, we deal with the subject very systematically and give the pupils a first-hand experience so that they can understand the subject and then work out the sums. We motivate the children to think and not just to get correct answers. Hence, we teach mathematics infused with logic, visual aids, and fun. Dear parents, here are a few clippings to reiterate the above-mentioned points. observe our young math geniuses involving themselves to gain a first-hand experience of the subject, both in classes 1 and 2. Are the books that will be used in class 1 and in class 2. The topics to be taught for both the classes are displayed on the screen. In class 1, number concepts range from 0 to 100. We continue from numbers 101 to 1000 for class 2. The topics included for number concepts are number names, numbers before, after, between, missing numbers, comparison of numbers greater than, equal to, lesser than, smallest and greatest numbers, ascending and descending numbers, tens and ones, abacus, expanded notation. Additional topics included in class 2 for number concepts are odd and even numbers, ordinal numbers and ordinal number names, place and place value. The other topics are addition, skip counting by twos, fives and tens, subtraction, measurement, shapes and patterns, time and calendar, money, data handling. Multiplication is taught in class 2 only. Every mathematical concept is introduced by following the three stages: concrete, pictorial, abstract. The teaching of the concept tens and ones is just one example where the above mentioned stages are followed. Here is a video presentation for the same. When in teaching addition and subtraction in class 1, the teacher approaches the topic, making use of the child's early experience of adding or subtracting. For example, in addition, the child sees that a group of 3 teddy bears combined with a group of 2 teddy bears makes a group of 5 teddy bears. This is known as the concrete stage. In the pictorial stage, pictures are used. For example, 2 flowers, the vocabulary word and, 3 flowers, the vocabulary term makes,
five flowers. The abstract stage numbers are used. Therefore, the number 2 is used and is replaced by the plus sign. The number 3 is used. Next is replaced by the equal sign and the number 5 is used. Addition is introduced as forward counting. In class 1, the children are taught single digit addition, horizontal and vertical, and two digit addition, horizontal and vertical, without regrouping. The number line is used to reinforce the topic. In class 2, for the topic addition, the concept of regrouping is taught to the children. The topics skip counting in 2s, 5s and 10s are taught in classes 1 and 2 according to the number concepts taught. Similarly, for the topic subtraction, the above mentioned stages are followed and subtraction is introduced as backward counting and without regrouping. In class 2, the concept of regrouping is introduced to the children. In class 2, we introduce multiplication as repeated addition of the same number. For example, 4 groups of 3 flowers in each is equal to 12. The addition sentence is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. The multiplication sentence is 4 into 3 equals 12. We teach them building of tables of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 10. Once the concept is clear, they make use of these tables to solve sums horizontally and vertically without regrouping, and also vertically with regrouping. In class 1, we introduce measurement in an informal way, like length is talked in terms of how long or how short an object is. For example, a long ribbon, a short ribbon. The table is dash cubit long. The classroom is dash paces. Weight is talked in terms of how heavy or light an object is. Capacity is talked in terms of more or less. For example, which container has more water and which has less. In class 2, the standard units of measurement are taught for length, centimeter, meter, and kilometer. For weight, grams and kilograms. And for capacity, milliliter or liter. In class 1, shapes are introduced by making them relate to various objects around them in the classroom and at home. Flat shapes, namely rectangle, square, triangle, circle, and oval, are taught. In class 2, the children are introduced to the solid shapes, namely sphere, cone, cylinder, cube, and cuboid. In class 1, the children are taught to read time in o'clock, where in class 2, they learn to read time as half past. For the topic calendar, the children learn to identify the days of the week and months in a year. A child normally gets his first idea of money from his shopping experience with adults. A child has to recognize the different denomination of the Omani currency, which is the Omani rial or baiza. Besides this, in class 2, the children are taught simple addition of denomination, concept of change received, simple subtraction of the denominations. Children also learn handling data in classes 1 and 2. But in class 1, there is an introduction to the topic. And in class 2, we teach them to collect data and organize the information from the given data. To teach all of the above topics, we use the following strategies. They are MATLAB activities, whiteboard drill, individual and group activities, audio visual aid, and worksheets. Reinforcement and constant encouragement brings about success in work. Therefore, reinforcement at home is very important. Thus, we can make mathematics an easy and enjoyable subject. Above all, to remember, nothing succeeds like success. Make haste slowly. Make the abstract concrete. Thank you. Now I call upon Ms. Anita Aguiar to speak about EVS.
Thank you, Jacinta, ma'am.
A very good morning to one and all. I, Anita Aguiar, along with my colleague, Mrs. Mariam, will guide you through the ways and means of teaching EVS in classes 1 and 2. Before I begin, I would like all of you to watch this video.
What a wonderful world.
wasn't the video an eye-opener for each one of us? The child viewing the world through her interaction with nature. Yes, EVS is all about knowing your environment and appreciating nature to develop a genuine concern and sensitivity towards its protection and preservation, a precious gift given to each one of us. The teaching of EVS largely contributes in developing habits, attitudes, and skills for being a healthy and an active member of the society. Let us watch a short video on all the activities conducted throughout the academic year. Children to try their hands at everything and their immeasurable contribution towards the building of a whole new world. The teaching of this subject is done mainly by dividing the topic into three categories: the natural aspects, the social aspects, and the cultural aspects. The natural aspects includes plants, animals, birds, the earth, the sky, and water. The social aspect includes man-made things like houses, roads, streets, means of transport, family customs, and festivals. The cultural aspect is the cultural environment that shapes the way that every person develops, influencing ideologies and personalities. Family and the relationship within the family are additional factors that determine a cultural environment. The textbook for this year are Frank Environmental Studies by Macmillan Publisher, Classes 1 and 2. Parents, please note that there is no separate EVS notebook. Keep a separate folder for the EVS worksheets. Topics covered for class 1 are as follows: me and my body, my family and my neighbors, food we eat, water, my home. Clothes people wear. We need air. Keeping clean and healthy. keeping safe my neighborhood. Plants are our green friends. Animals around us, going around, means of communication, sky and weather. Topics covered for class 2 are as follows. Me and my body, my family and neighbors, food I eat, water, houses we live in, air, cleanliness, keeping clean and healthy, safety, people and places around us. Plants around us, animals around us, how we travel, means of communication, the sky, sun, moon and stars, time and direction. These are the general knowledge textbooks for classes 1 and 2. Please note how the evaluation of learning outcomes is done on the basis of day-to-day observation of the performance of the child, oral questioning, quizzes through Google Forms, worksheets, work done in the EVS textbook, PowerPoint presentations, participation in class discussions, activity videos prepared by teachers.
Dear parents, let's try out a Padlet activity. For demo, few teachers will respond to this Padlet activity. Teachers, please follow the steps to do the activity. Open the Google browser or Google Lens. Scan the QR code. The text Padlet appears on your mobile screen. Click on the text. Now start the activity by clicking on the plus sign. Now start answering the questions. What is your name? Which is your favorite animal? Once you finish this, click on the publish button. Teachers, for participating in the activity. Parents, a similar Padlet activity will be done in the class using the smart boards and BenQ boards. Just a gentle reminder, parents, the study material is uploaded on the school website regularly. Worksheets, textbook pages, and activities done during class are to be completed. Regular practice of spellings from the units taught should be given to the children. Maintain a folder to file the worksheets done during the class.
The methods and techniques used are using pictures and charts, using newspaper clippings, making collages, brainstorming, data collection like flowers and pictures, etc. Organizing excursions and visits to parks, zoos, etc. Yes, parents, together we may give our children roots to grow and wings to fly.
A new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no. Where to go? A new world, a new fantastic.
Thank you. Now I call upon Mrs. Pooja to orient you on the subject computer science taught in classes 1 and 2.
Thank you, Anita, ma'am. Learning computer science is not about computers anymore. It is about empowering students to create the world of tomorrow. Warm greetings to all of you. I, Pooja Sampat, and my colleague, Ms. Rebecca Edwin, are excited to represent the Department of Computer Science of the Primary Wing to orient you for classes 1 and 2. Computer education is an activity-based subject which mainly aims at developing the skills of using the technology, helping the children to become creative and innovative, learning while playing various educational softwares, helping children to improve the skills on using different peripherals. IT Planet, streaming without buffering with Windows 10 and MS Office 2016, will be the textbook that will be followed this year. The textbook contains interesting exercises and fun-filled activities at the end of every chapter. Dear parents, please note that no notebook is required for computer science for classes 1 and 2. The syllabus of classes 1 and 2 displayed on the screen for your reference. We will be having 2 sessions for computer science per week. The children participate eagerly in the practical sessions, and the theory sessions are also dealt in the lab, so they learn them with hands-on experience. This is basement computer lab used exclusively for classes 1 and 2. For class 1, TuxPaint and GCompress will be introduced. TuxPaint is a free drawing program for children and is used for computer literacy drawing activities. GCompress and MathAhead are free educational software suite comprising of many activities for children. For class 2, advanced level of TuxPaint will be covered along with MS Paint and WordPad. Dear parents, we request you to assist your wards by downloading these software in your personal computers, which will enable them to practice these software at home, besides practice given to them at school. Moving to assessment, pre-midterm and midterm examination will be conducted for term 1, while post-midterm and final examination paper will be conducted for term 2. The portion for the assessment will be revised well to instill confidence in students to face the assessment with confidence. Besides the theoretical assessment, students will also be evaluated for practicals based on their work in the computer lab. There will be one subject enrichment activity per term, which will also be evaluated. This year, we will be organizing awareness campaign for National Technology Day to commemorate the achievements of scientists, researchers, engineers, and all others involved in the field of science and technology. DigiSavvy Hunt from the Department of Computer Science is a competition-based event to boost the competitive spirits of students to showcase their digital skills. Details of competition will be conveyed well in advance through the announcements in Google Classroom, so that students will get adequate time to prepare themselves for the competition. Here we present the video showcasing the brilliant digital artwork of our keen pupils prepared during DigiSavvy Hunt of Academic Year 2021-2022. The Department of Computer Science is headed by Ms. Ambika Padmanabhan. Ms. Rebecca Edwin will be handling grade 1 and I, Pooja Sampat, will be handling grade 2. You are welcome to get in touch with us through email if you require any clarifications. We seek your cooperation to help us to provide effective learning for our learners. Technology is in our hands. Let's guide our children to use it wisely. Here is Master Kaustu sharing his feedback regarding his experience on learning software in computer science.
Hello everyone, I am Kaustu, studying in class 2D. Last year at school, we learned Tux Paint. It was so much fun drawing and painting. My favorite was to draw buildings and sceneries. My teacher also taught us how to draw cartoons and birds. There are many colors in the color palette. There are many tools such as shape, line and stamp. But my favorite tool is a magic tool. We were all waiting for computer class every week. Have fun. Bye-bye.
I wish our dear students, parents, and teachers to have an excellent academic year 2022-2023. Thank you. Now I invite Mr. Matthew to brief about Malayalam language.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Good afternoon, dear parents and children. Welcome to this orientation program. First of all, I would like to thank our principal and the management committee for starting Malayalam as a second language in the first standard. Until now, Malayalam was started from the sixth standard. it was a long standing need of the parents that Malayalam should start from the primary level. Now we are in the position to offer Malayalam from class 1. For every person, his first language is his mother tongue. It is through that language he understands about his culture and customs. മാതൃഭാഷയുടെ ഈ മഹത്വം മനസ്സിലാക്കിയാണ് ദേശസ്നേഹികളായ കവികളും കലാകാരന്മാരും അതിനേറെ പ്രാധാന്യം നൽകുന്നത്. വള്ളത്തോൾ ഇങ്ങനെ എഴുതുന്നു, മറ്റുള്ള ഭാഷകൾ കേവലം ധാത്രിമാർ, മർത്തിനു പെറ്റമ്മ തൻ ഭാഷതാൻ. മലയാളികളെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം മലയാളമാണ് മാതൃഭാഷ. നമ്മുടെ മാതൃഭാഷയെ, മലയാളത്തെ ചേർത്ത് പിടിക്കേണ്ടത് നമ്മുടെ കടമയാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് മലയാളം സെക്കൻഡ് ലാംഗ്വേജായി എടുക്കാനും മലയാളം പഠിക്കാനും കുട്ടികളെ നിർബന്ധിക്കണമെന്ന് വിനയത്തോടെ അഭ്യർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. നൗ ലെറ്റ് മീ ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് മലയാളം ടീച്ചേഴ്സ്, മിസ്റ്റർ മുരുകൻ, മിസ്റ്റർ പ്രമോദ്, മിസ്സസ് അനിത ആൻഡ് മൈസെൽഫ്. വി ഫോർ ആർ ഹാൻഡിലിംഗ് മലയാളം ഇൻ ISWK അറ്റ് പ്രസൻറ്റ്. മിസ്റ്റർ മുരുകൻ വിൽ ബി ഹാൻഡിലിംഗ് ദി ക്ലാസ്സസ് ഇൻ ദി ഫസ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റാൻഡേർഡ്. He is a very experienced teacher. This is the textbook we are going to use in the first standard. This book is available in our bookstore. The Malayalam teacher will collect the books and distribute them to the student in the class as early as possible. Two notebooks are required, one for classwork and one for practice. This will also be distributed in the class. These are the scholastic activities we are going to conduct this academic year: picture comprehension, storytelling, rhyme recitation, spell check, and word puzzle. This is the assessment pattern: letters, letter combinations, word formation, sentence formation, and picture identification. These are some pictures of the activities we conducted in main school 2021-22. These are the Malayalam toppers of class 10 2020-21 who scored 99% in the board exam. This is the result analysis of Malayalam class 10 KM1 CBSE examination 2021-22, present batch. Out of 107 students, 15 students got full marks. 40 students got 90% above. Very few students only got below 60% marks. So Malayalam is a very top scoring subject, and without any extra coaching, students can get very good mark. വർഷം മലയാളം ഒന്നാം ക്ലാസ്സിൽ മലയാളം പഠിക്കുന്ന കുട്ടികൾക്ക് മാത്രമേ മെയിൻ സ്കൂളിൽ ആറാം ക്ലാസ്സിൽ മലയാളം സെക്കൻഡ് ലാംഗ്വേജ് ആയി പഠിക്കാൻ അവസരം ലഭിക്കുകയുള്ളൂ. മാത്രമല്ല, കേരളത്തിൽ പഠിക്കുന്നതിനും ജോലി നേടുന്നതിനും കേരള സർക്കാർ മലയാളം നിർബന്ധമാക്കിയിട്ടുമുണ്ട്. അതുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മുടെ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് മലയാളം പഠിക്കാൻ സ്കൂളിൽ അവസരം ലഭിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത് പരമാവധി പ്രയോജനപ്പെടുത്താൻ അഭ്യർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ദിസ് ഈസ് അവർ mail ID and contact number. If you have any queries, you can contact us at this mail ID or phone number. This is the general information about Malayalam. Before concluding this session, I would like to recite one sentence from the great epic Ramayana. In Ramayana, the sage Valmiki says, Janani janma bhumischa swargadapi gariyasi. Its meaning is, the mother and the motherland is greater than the heaven. Those who give importance to mother, mother tongue, and motherland will definitely reach the top. Thank you. Now I invite Mr. Shifas to explain about the co-scholastic activities.
Thank you, Matthew, sir. For give the briefing about the subject Malayalam. Let me share my screen. Okay, parents, let me start. The development of child's body and mind demand proper nurturing of their physical and intellectual qualities. These are major determinants of child's personality. Therefore, modern approaches of education emphasize on the all-round development of child. A very good afternoon, dear parents. Today, I, Shifas, the PE coordinator of the primary section, will brief you on the importance of co-scholastic education, especially in the current scenario, the grading pattern, and the activities which will be conducted for the academic year 2022-23. It's a well-known fact that the academic subjects ensure across different levels. However, co-scholastic activities, when taught and conducted along with the scholastic subject, ensure proper continuity of academic learning, because these activities help to maintain stable emotional and physical health. It has often been said, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. Co-scholastic activities will help develop a sense of competitive spirit, cooperation, leadership, healthy recreation, self-discipline, self-confidence, diligence, punctuality, team spirit, as well as provide a backdrop for the development of child's creative talents. This has become all the more important after schools have reopened after a long gap of almost 2 years. The shift from online to on-site will be slightly challenging. However, with the help of co-scholastic activities, the task becomes more easier for both the children and teachers. Let's look at the different co-scholastic activities offered at ISWK. We have fine art, like art and craft, performing art, which includes dance, music, and of course, physical education covering aerobics and yoga. The academic year is divided into two terms. Term one, from April 2022 to September 2022, and term two, from October 2022 to March 2023. The evaluation for term one will be slightly liberal. We scholastic teachers will take into account the cumulative grades of each child's and interaction and performance of the current academic year 2022-23. For the term two, the grading will be based on the interaction and performance during the regular classes, participation in the various activities, and subject knowledge. Now let's meet the vibrant team of co-scholastic teachers. For arts, we have Mr. Sandeep and Mrs. Samreen Zaid. For dance, we have Mrs. Vanita. For music, we have Mrs. Asha Mohan, Mrs. Snehal, and Mr. Stanley. And for physical education, we have Mr. Shifas, Mr. David Kennedy, Mr. Sijo, Mrs. Angeline, Mrs. Lisa, exclusively for aerobics, and Mr. Pranav, exclusively for yoga. As far as the syllabus is concerned, each scholastic activity will begin with introduction and basic concepts in class one and two, and will gradually shift towards more intricate and fine aspects as the children move to class three, four, and five. The syllabus will be shared on a monthly basis in the school website. Last year, we had music competitions and dance competitions. Class-wise competition will be announced time to time. Sports and games inter-house calendar is updated in the school website, and the same will be shared in the Google Classroom. With regard to games and sports, we have the ISWK Academy, which is a huge success, and it involves variety of sports and games for both kids and parents. We offer various team sports and individual sports. The game like cricket, football, badminton, basketball, volleyball, table tennis, handball, chess, hockey are very few games we excel in Oman clusters as well as in CBSE nationals. A game like skating, yoga, and aerobics are our special highlights which no other Indian schools in Oman is offered. There are fee and free coaching classes at ISWK Academy, the details of which are available in the school website under the sports and games option. For any further details you can and clarification, you can contact me at shifas@iswkoman.com. Next, to commemorate the 8th International Yoga Day, the Physical Education Department is conducting yoga activities every Saturday morning from 6:30 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. at the senior school ground. The flyer that you can see on the screen is shared on the school website, where all you'll need to find a link to register. Please don't miss the fabulous opportunity to tune your mind and body. I would like to conclude by saying that before we rush to pressure and push our children out of the arts, let's think more carefully and listen more attentively to the voices and hearts of these young minds. Let us ignite and fan their passion and encourage a broad liberal education, which is the sole motto of our prestigious school that values them as young people. With the heart as well as mind, with dreams as well as ambitions. We look forward to your support and continued cooperation in our future endeavor. Thank you. Now I call Rashmi ma'am to brief about the ABLE team.
Thank you so much, Shifas sir. A very good afternoon to all. As Shifas sir mentioned about all the co-scholastic activities, make sure your children participate actively in it because as they grow up, not only the academic, but the co-scholastic also has a lot of weightage and people prefer who have a balanced approach towards this. A child is like a butterfly in the wind. Some can fly higher than others, but each one flies the best it can. Why compare one against the other? Each one is different, each one is special, and each one is beautiful. I'm Mrs. Rashmi Patankar, department in charge of the Psychology, Counseling, and Special Needs Department at ISWK. ABLE, that is the name of the department, which stands for Advise, Believe, Learn, and Elevate. The past 2 years have been very difficult for all of us, and the most affected have been the students, but now we are all bouncing back. The major aim of guidance counseling services is to encourage students' academic, social, emotional, personal, and career development. To reach this aim, guidance and counseling services at ISWK help students to get to know themselves better and find effective solutions to their daily problems. To help and support our learners, parents, and teachers, we have a very robust team of counselors and special educators. We have Mrs. Avni Wade. She's our psychology teacher and main school counselor. We have Mrs. Neha Cherian. She's our career counselor, psychology teacher, and counselor for the main school. We have Mrs. Shamita Anjan. She is our special educator for the main school. And we have Mrs. Rohini Swaminathan, who will be updating you about the procedures and the services available at the KGN Primary. She is the KGN Primary counselor. Over to you, Rohini.
Thank you, Rashmi ma'am. A very good afternoon to one and all present here this afternoon. I will be briefing about the services offered by the psychology, counseling, and special education department of the school. We at the ABLE department, we believe all the students have the ability to be successful in life and in school when provided with appropriate support and interventions. We believe all the students are unique individuals capable of success with their own personal strengths and talents. We believe all the students have the right to a safe and nurturing academic environment that supports and enhances their personal growth. Under the CBSE guidelines, the school follows the policy of inclusive education and accommodation for children with special needs. The students and parents are provided with the following support. Guidance and counseling is offered to both students and parents depending on the need. Informal assessments are carried out by the respective counselor or special educator in the form of classroom observations, identifying the special needs students in a class, offering remedial sessions to those who seek remedial assistance, individual exam support for students seeking exam assistance. External references are also provided. For instance, if a child requires additional therapy like occupational therapy, speech therapy, behavior therapy, etc., we do refer them externally. Shadow support is also provided by the schools. So we also have a provision of shadow support wherein we facilitate shadow support for children with special needs. Parent individual sessions are carried out depending on the need. We also assist the teachers and parents with regards to the referrals. Here is a glimpse of the new resource room at the KG building, dear parents. Dear parents, let us all go for a virtual tour to the new resource room. As you can see in the video, the room is big and colorful. It consists of a variety of toys, books, puzzles, and other educational resources catering to different needs of a child. I'm sure all of you must be thinking about this question. So when exactly should a parent consult a counselor? Here are a few pointers which might help you, dear parents. Developmental delay in milestones, such as if you find that your child has started speaking late or there is a delay in development of their fine motor skills or gross motor skills, in such cases, you can approach a counselor. Students with learning difficulties, any behavior change in the child that is unusual or sudden, children who exhibit aggressive behavior. Guidance is also offered to the parents. Sometimes parents need guidance in the form of tips to improve certain specific areas of concern, bullying, personal issues, etc. Regular in-house workshops, competitions, and activities are planned and conducted by the ABLE team for the students, teachers, and for parents as well. Dear parents, for regular updates, follow us on our Instagram page, ABLE_ISWK. So what exactly is the procedure that we follow in our department? I'm sure this must be the question running in most of your mind. So the procedure followed in our department is as follows. Referral form, usually a referral form is filled in by the parent or a teacher. In case of higher grades, we also have a provision of self-referrals. Once the referral forms are filled, observations are carried out by the respective counselor or special educator. Counseling sessions are offered for both students and parents depending on the need. Informal assessments are also carried out for children with special needs. Dear parents, kindly note, no formal testing is done at school. If a parent wishes to seek assistance from our department in the form of remedial support, exam support, or counseling sessions, it is mandatory that they sign the parent consent form. Dear parents, kindly note that it is mandatory that you sign in the parent consent form in order to avail the services offered by the department. Special education program in the form of IEP, that is individual education program, are also designed by our department depending on the need of the child. External references are also provided just in case the child requires additional therapy. The contact details of the counselors and special educator are up on the screen. Dear parents, you can take them down. Kindly feel free to approach us and reach out to us at any point of time. I'm sure it has been a journey of ups and downs for all of us for the past 2 years. It has been a challenging roller coaster ride to unlearn what has been learned and to relearn what has to be. Though it was a challenging ride, it was better because we were in this together. Dear parents, I would like to draw your attention towards these parent tips of the day. I'm sure all of us present here would definitely agree that COVID-19 has not been easy for all of us, particularly our children. So here are a few tips which might be of help to you. Children need a minimum of 8 touches during a day to feel connected to a parent. It could be as simple as straightening of a collar, a pat on the shoulder, or a simple good morning hug. Each day, children need one meaningful eye-to-eye conversation with a parent. I'm sure because of the pandemic, all of us have forgotten the skill of what is it like to have an eye-to-eye contact conversation. Research has shown there are 9 minutes during the day that have the greatest impact on a child. The first 3 minutes after they wake up, the 3 minutes after they come home from school, the last 3 minutes before they go to bed. Dear parents, it's a humble request. We need to make those moments special and help our children feel loved. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Wishing all of you a great, successful academic year ahead. I now hand over the session to Seema ma'am.
Thank you, Rohini ma'am, and the counseling department for your constant support, not only to the students, but to us teachers too. Parents, we have now come to the end of the orientation program. As they say, well begun is half done. We put our best foot forward and look ahead to a year full of learning and development. I am Senior Supervisor Seema Pereira for classes 1 to 5. Please mail me at supervisorprimary@iswkoman.com for constructive feedback or any assistance whatsoever. We truly believe in extending all and full support to our students and you, the parent community. I also take this opportunity to wish in advance all the parents who celebrate Easter. May you experience peace and joy as you celebrate Easter this year. I call upon Mrs. Vanessa Travis to propose the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Seema ma'am. We cannot end today's orientation session without expressing our gratitude to the people who made it possible for all of us. We would like to extend our sincere thanks to the SMC for always believing in Team ISWK. Thanks to our principal, vice principals, and academic supervisor for being a guiding light for all of us and mentoring us to give our best. I would also like to thank academic coordinators, team of teachers, and the IT department for all the endless help and support in making the session a fruitful one. Last but not the least, I take this opportunity to thank you, dear parents, for your virtual presence here today, and also for your patient listening. The last academic year too went off successfully with the cooperation and support of you parents. Thank you once again. Let me end with a quote by Helen Keller. Alone, we can do so little. Together, we can do so much. Let us work towards building that trusted partnership between home and school. Looking forward to a great experience.